What a beautiful day it is today here at the house. It's like 62 degrees. It's going to get hot. It's going to get extremely hot and it's going to get humid. So we're going to want some shade out here. We're going to try to put up some sunshade. And I think they also call them shade sails. We're going to try to do it on the cheap, guys, on the cheap. How do you attach it to the house when you got gutters? And I got a solution for that, so you're going to have to stay tuned. And I wimped out. I ended up going with the 4x6s instead of the 6x6s, which is still going to be pretty strong for what we have here. We're going to try to put a shade on this structure. We're going to try to make it beautiful. Let's get started. That's one hole. Two more. One more hole. You want to know what's fun about some projects is when you run into something unexpectedly. And in this particular case, that is exactly the case.
Look, it's a nice little irrigation pipe. Yeah.
I'm going to have to dig more. It's going to create a lot more work, hours more of time just to do this tiny little $1.50 fix. What a pain. But I did get the other two holes dug 3 feet down, which gives me about a 9 foot tall post here.
Take a look. Not too bad, not too shabby. And I got the other one over there.
Now another project that I'll have to do now is the water feature, which I do definitely want out here. You know, it's another one of those things. I knew this one was gonna have to happen though, because I needed that post right there and the water feature just was in the way. I could probably build it around it, so that may not be that big of a deal, but also when you're doing something, sometimes you wanna upgrade things. So that's what's going on with the water feature. We're gonna upgrade the thing. Make it just a little bit better than it was. The last hole, I was halfway through the last hole. But anyways, let's get back to it. So what I've done here is I drilled a couple holes. There's one there. One there, and basically I'm gonna pour a form out here that comes out, and so it looks like it's an extension of this patio, and I'm gonna tie it into the patio so I don't get any of that shifting back and forth or up or down, and hopefully it holds it nice and tight to the patio. Different day, but we're back at it again. It is much sunnier today. I need some shade, so that's why we're doing this. And I know I'm gonna get sunburned if I don't put this thing on, so. Anyways, I need to attach it to the house, right? And so the problem was I had these gutters. I can't just attach it to this end piece right here. That's just not enough. I can drill in through here, through the other side of the gutter, and into that rafter. I'm going to be using this 5/16 drill bit here. Bought this the other day at Home Depot. It's about 14 inches long. And that way I'm able to get through my gutter and into my rafter easily without having to get some weird angles on it. So this is one nice long drill bit. Roll it right in there, baby. put some boards across, basically from this post all the way over to the other side post over there. I got 2x8 board, going to stain them just like the others and put them up. Itself. I think it's about a 450-500 pound carabiner. Then you have 250 pound chain going to a turnbuckle, getting it nice and tight, just like so. Set up here. It's going to provide great shade for the summer. Made one extra improvement here. You can see this extra bolt here that I got in here. So that's when the rain comes in. It will actually end up pulling in the middle of the shade cells, and so I can just unclip them from the top there, bring them down, and that water rolls right off. And so that's really, really important because you don't want the weight of that water to break anything you got going on right now. If you enjoyed the video, please like and share. Subscribe to my channel, and until next time, I'll see you on the next one. Thank you.